What's going on, guys, and welcome to Gameville TV.
Yeah? Should have kept going. Like...
Like holding it out?
No. I mean, you started off real good and okay. Then you just stopped talking. You know.
I left it in there?
It's like saying, welcome, and then standing in front of the doorway so nobody can go in.
Just, hi!
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah. Pretty much how
that goes. Welcome to today's show, guys. It's been a while. It's been about a week since we saw you Dragon Blaze, guys, so I know I missed you guys deeply. So today's show is going to be all about, we have a new set of Awakened Allies coming out. We have Calgar and Rollo, because, I mean, we do need, I think we're kind of lacking some Archer Awakened Allies. So, you know, we're going to go ahead and throw another one in with this set of Awakened Allies to kind of just change it up a little bit,
yeah.
You know? So we're throwing one archer and then one healer ally at you guys. And then we're implementing the much-awaited Guild Adventure game mode. So those two features are going to be in this next coming update for Dragon Blaze. So we're going to talk a little bit about it. You know, you guys are going to earn some points. We're going to have some laughs. We're gonna
maybe.
You know, maybe some explosions. Yeah. Emotionally, you know, speaking, not real.
Right.
So, please don't.
Craftsman, no, I didn't see your message yet. I'll get on my Twitch account and take a look.
So cool. Maybe some singing, though. I don't know.
Ooh.
We could. I will. Some of the flavor text, though, for these characters are very. It's becoming a little more descriptive now, so maybe we'll throw some RP in there a little bit.
That's always great.
I know. Or yeah. I could wrap more of the descriptions, whatever you guys want, but maybe limited to a couple of things, though. So, anyway, you guys won't hear me talking anymore, so let's go ahead and jump on in here immediately into game. So, you have to bear with us here, guys, because even though we have two Awakened Allies, obviously the big feature is going to be Guild Adventure, so that's going to be probably a majority of today's show is going through there. Obviously, we'll probably have people coming in throughout the show, maybe not catching some of the information we're throwing at you guys. So, yeah, the Guild Adventure mode does take some time to actually get through, though, but we'll talk more about that in a few minutes. First of all, though, we're going to go ahead and jump into the new... the newest set of Awakened Allies coming to Dragon Blaze. And first and foremost, we're going to take a look at Rollo the Inventor. Before we take a look at her abilities, let's go ahead and show her off in here. I do currently have the what's called effects turned down because I was running some stuff earlier, so obviously I wanted to not bog down the device or anything. So obviously some of the abilities look kind of not too great with her. Let me turn it on then. That just looks ridiculous.
Yeah, what are you doing, man?
You know, not really thinking things through sometimes.
Oh.
You know, just being honest.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Stupid. Did you like your raid session yesterday? Oh, yeah. No, that was cool. Hey, I raided with some of you guys, Craftsman. I think Dark Shadow was in that group too. So, yeah, that was cool times. Just running some Ragnarok. Getting some epic gear. Boom. So she uses a lot of, obviously, her cannon is the main source of her damage. But she'll occasionally kind of throw in a couple of her attacks, though, too. So one of the cool things with Rollo's Awaken is that I think it's kind of like a lot of the Awaken characters kind of have some kind of ability that will be affected by either like another ability or a passive of some sort. So there's a lot of in-depth skills that you kind of have to use with one another and stuff like that, right? So it's pretty cool. So that's the kind of animations that we're looking at. So let's look at Rollo the Inventor Princess. King Langner sent the princess on a long journey in order for her to build experience in the real world. So a father sent his child out into the world, basically said, you're on your own, figure it out, right? That's harsh, man. Who would do that? Who could do that?
I don't think she's going to survive very long, though. She seems a bit lazy at this point.
You think so?
Yeah, man. She's just riding around on her chariot, shooting cannons at people. I mean, what happens when you run out of cannonballs?
Why not? Synergy! Yeah. There's a lot of abilities that you get it. What's it called? Princess Rollo is doing a great job so far on this tough journey on a small sailboat and her tiny fen. Parody? We'll say parody because it's a parrot. Squawk, squawk, right?
Where is it?
Tiny friend.
Perotti?
Perotti.
Okay.
Socle bleu, Perotti.
Wow.
Rollo's normal attacks affect all enemies. So her normal attacks basically are splash damage attacks then. First ability we have here are fireworks. Because, baby, you are a firework.
Oh, I dislike you so much right now.
What?
I just got that.
And, do you ever feel like
real quick,
like
Bertrand, yeah, since you redeemed a ridiculous amount of stuff, it's probably going to take a little bit longer than normal. So just kind of hang out and kind of keep coordinating with John, and eventually we'll get you stuff.
Yeah, I like to imagine it's a sailboat attached to just a truck. So it could be a boat, in a sense. So maybe the front cannon is dragging it behind. I got nothing.
Wow.
So fireworks, first ability, roll those cannonballs, explode in the sky, igniting it. You just gotta ignite. With fire and shrapnel, inflicts 895% damage on all enemies and stuns them for 10 seconds at a 70% chance.
It's not a sailboat, it's a schooner.
It is a schooner. Good call, I like it. Second ability we have here, vacuum annihilation bullet. Launches a powerful warhead that sucks in the surrounding air before exploding. Inflicts damage equal to 689% damage of attack on all enemies. Dispels any invulnerability and then follows up with an additional 883% damage. So you get hit by a warhead that doesn't go off, right? Boom, it hits you. It waits to detonate and then it detonates, deals more damage. So it's kind of cool. More so that you're just getting, it's just like a warhead's being thrown at you. Uh-huh. I like that. I like that more so than anything. How it seems just gets lazy. Thrown at you. Yeah. It's like she throws it, boom. Sit on that for a while. Boom, there it is.
Wow.
Boom. You guys see the theme here? Last ability we have is, there it is.
Nice.
Makes accurate, okay, this one's a bit of a doozy, okay. Marks accurate coordinates with the eyes of a clever marksman. Trustworthy party members always have your back. Increases Rollo's skill cooldown speed by 50%. Changes supporting fire, which is a passive, to splash attacks for 10 seconds. And then increases attack and speeds up your cannonball attack cycles. So, we'll get into the passive right now really quickly. But essentially what this does is it increases your attack speed, right? And then it changes your passive. So the passive that we're looking at is essentially support fire, which essentially will, occasionally cannonball strikes will come in and basically hit an individual target, okay? I'm not sure, I think it's more so like a passive that works like kind of like Death Crowns, where I think it's like, it might be random, like this obviously doesn't really say when those actual cannonball strikes come in, but normally it's just a single target hit. With there it is active though, those cannonball strikes will then turn into splash damage as well too. So she's got a lot of AoE damaging abilities in her kit though, so I could see maybe something like Hydra working in that, but I mean, I think she's more so beneficial in just regular dungeons though at this point. So
a little lazy and privileged to me,
just because she's sitting in a chair and it's basically her the cannon on this thing is basically doing the whole.
You could just leave her at home, just bring the cam.
Well, she marks targets with there it is, so she stands up and points at targets for other people.
I'm pretty sure I can get the parrot to do that.
So I don't know. I believe that's an incorrect a typo where it says the Varman race is always supportive on of the princess's battle. Rollo may seem irritated, but he. Nah. I think it's she. I'm pretty sure that's a she, and it was just a typo. Supports Rollo by launching cannonballs from Rollo's pirate ship. And then the unviewed passive is Rollo's special NP36 cannonball disperses powerful shrapnel, applies 33% of fixed damage to all of Rollo's attacks.
Avastin wants to know if she comes in like a cannonball.
Wow, that took me way more time to figure out what that meant than I care to admit. But
and I hope it hurt you deeply.
It didn't. I actually felt pretty good about it, but you know. So let me do a couple of dungeon runs, guys, just to kind of show you her kit. And let me just make sure I have it set. Okay, cool. Battle effects on. And dungeon run. What's MP an abbreviation for? Nuclear power?
No problem.
No problem? Let's see. I don't know. Do we get level 90 rewards? You want? Why would you get them now? You've already been 90.
I think they were saying because the Korean version got.
Oh.
I mean, you're not going to get them right now. If they do decide to give them out, I'm sure that they will send them out eventually.
Yeah. Plus, you guys want to follow your own set of rules, right? Don't keep looking at what they're doing. You guys follow your own path.
Yeah.
Yeah. That didn't work, did it?
I mean...
Slow joke.
Maybe, I don't know. Maybe if you would have said it with some more gravitas. Maybe. That might have worked. But, I mean,
but that's a good argument, too. But free stuff. And at this point in the negotiation, I would say... Eh?
Yeah?
Yeah.
That had a lot less conviction behind
please,
it.
Please, sir?
Yeah?
Please?
Wow.
Sir?
That's good.
Don't be mad.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's good.
Woo! Is Spirit Parrot gifted to her by Monolandi? Are you sure? Is that for real?
No.
Oh. Because she's... I get it. Okay. Yeah, I do think the parrot, though, is pretty dope, though, that she has with her. He's just there. Look at him.
I don't know.
Who brings a parrot into battle, though, with him? Pirates?
Pirates? I guess, maybe.
Hipphonics, what's up? I see you calling my name. And the second time was all caps. You know that's serious business, then.
Yeah.
Yeah. When is the special growth jar going to be updated? No plans currently. And I haven't heard anything quite yet, but, I mean, rest assured, whenever we do get information, we'll be here.
I know when Chapter 4 started, they updated the growth jars, but I don't know if they're going to be updating them for level 100 or whenever we eventually raise the level cap.
Yeah.
So, I wouldn't hold my breath.
I'm doing good. How are you doing, Hiphonics? Thanks for asking. You know, we get people in here every week, and sometimes people just, you know, just bombard people.
I think that's My Love Kim.
Oh. Oh, hey, what's up, My Love Kim? Okay, all right. Is it? I think you're lying. All right, guys. Next up. The most rootinest, tootinest, wolf-ridingest, spirit-summoning guy around town.
Joe's a blonde at heart.
Oh. Oh. Is Calgar, the master of spirits.
Yeah? What was that? Oh my god.
I owe you money. Dang. Can we boot him? Boot him from chat.
Boot him from chat.
I got the bookies coming into just Twitch now. Like, where's my money?
Oh.
Calgar, the master of spirits. His undeniable influence over his souls protects the allies with his blessings and subjugates enemies with the punishing energy of Earth and the sky. Calgar's powerful abilities even has Azur wanting to become allies with him. Dang, Azur sounds just like he just wants like the best.
Who even is that?
I don't know.
That's what I'm saying. Like, they introduce a character you're supposed to be like, whoa, that dude?
Yeah, it might as well be like, even has Bob wanting to be his friend. Like,
whoa.
Bob, yeah. Like, Azur.
Isn't that Commander Azur?
It could be.
John, shut up. Man. Come on, man. John. Are you kidding me, man? You're coming in here with logic. We're trying to make fun of this. Commander Azur. There you go, guys. All right. That's the kind of knowledge that we kind of obtained here before
the
show.
Yeah, didn't he die?
Boom. He did.
Didn't somebody die? Yeah.
Well, just because you're dead doesn't mean you can't have friends. Casper's got friends. Normal attacks will have increased defense penetration. First ability we have here is the Grand Punishment. The atmospheric energy fulfills Calgar's wishes by granting divine punishment. Inflict 1,306 damage on all enemies and reduce their attack speed by 49% for 8 seconds. Earth's Fury, second ability. Spirit King Boris, I don't know who Boris is either, so... is the envoy of the Earth. Envy of the Earth?
Envoy.
Envoy of the Earth.
God.
By his command, the earth dances. I can't. Oh my god, I'm getting dyslexic right now. I'm becoming dyslexic.
Are we gonna have to put you in like ESL or something?
By his command, the earth dances and doesn't forgive anyone who steps foot on the ground. Cast Earth Fury on all enemies that last 8 seconds and inflicts 528% damage every 1.5 seconds. And the damage enemy is then, or the enemy has potential to be stunned for 8 seconds at a 70% chance. Didn't go to public school, by the way. does it show? So a couple things to note about this ability, and when I say a couple of things, I actually mean one thing, is that since Earth Fury is, let me show you actually what it looks like. So it's basically cast, it's basically cast multiple times, right? So he does it for 8 seconds, and then he does basically a strike every 1.5 seconds. You can potentially be hit by this stun, or you can miss the first couple of stuns, but each actual attack has a chance to stun. Mm-hmm. So you could potentially be hit on the first attack, be stunned, hit on the second attack, be stunned. The stun chance or the stun time doesn't actually stack, so it'll just be refreshed back to 8 seconds every single time it does hit. Or it could hit the last one, and then you could be stunned on that one. So, yeah, I know, right, Purifier? He kind of looks like it at this point. That definitely looks, yeah, that looks like Thrall on a war pig.
Not so much.
And backing out. So, yeah, keep that in mind, guys. You can potentially be, yeah, stun locked in a sense. It would have been even, I had to actually ask and make sure to clarify that it wasn't, like, stacking on top of one another, right? So you're hit, like, twice in a row, and it's, like, 16 seconds. But, yeah, they told me that's not the case. It's basically, if it does hit multiple times, it just refreshes the actual stun on you. Last ability we have here is Spirit Wolf Leader. Spirit Wolves who once made a deal with Calgar share their souls for peace of mind. Spirit Wolves who once made a deal with Calgar share their souls for peace of mind. So they like gave him his soul? They gave him their soul?
Why do they need peace of mind? They're dead.
Yeah, they give him the souls, right? Ooh.
Are they just like ripcording on life? They're like, you know what? Peace of mind is going to be me dying. So I'm just going to sacrifice myself to you.
Oh, summons two spirit wolves for 20 seconds and then recovers party members' HP by 60% of the damage inflicted by the spirit wolves. So I've always found Calgar to be pretty cool in the sense that he's a healer. Same, I think, with Monolandi, right? That does, they can do damage as well as heal their actual team members. So I know it's especially useful for those like predicaments maybe where you need more damage and maybe you have too many heals in your party or something like that. So and the wolves like that he actually summons can actually deal some pretty good damage. So you can actually see some pretty good numbers coming back from the actual time that they're left out.
Matrix Dan, if you're having an issue with that, go ahead and message the @GameVilleUSA, and John can figure out what's going on.
Yeah, Rusbucks, I guess I could see that. I could see what you're saying in that regard. So yeah, I mean, it's kind of finicky though, right? It's like, you know, you're kind of at the beck and call of RNG because like you could technically cast the ability and hit no stuns, but then you can also cast the ability and potentially what the scenario that you basically just laid out, which is like you get stunned this time. It's a 1.5 second cast. You've already been stunned twice or for 2 seconds, and then it hits you again. So yeah, I don't know. If we do start seeing a lot of issues or a lot of anybody, because I haven't really heard anybody like abusing this in any of the versions of like, you know, Calgar stun being overpowered or anything like that. So, but I mean, I guess time will kind of tell and see where, we'll kind of see where the ability lies though in like the global portion of the game. But yeah, we'll see kind of how it plays out. And looking at his passives, we have the Wolf Pack. Weapons of Iron Wolf Tribe are the most extraordinary among of their kind and bring out the warrior's strength to the fullest. Increases Calgar's weapon attack by 27%. And then recovers party members' HP by 70% of the damage inflicted by Calgar's two abilities, Divine Punishment and Earth Fury. So both these abilities, when they hit, will actually heal your party member for 70% of the damage it does.
So they never give you any backstory why he's on a pig instead of a wolf this time?
Well, because he took the spirits of the wolf, right? So I'm sure he just had to find some other beast that isn't just so giving of their souls, you know? I'm sure he respects the boar.
Maybe he got fat.
The pig?
No.
Or the wolf?
Calgar.
Oh.
Wolves couldn't support him anymore. Maybe that's what it was. They're like, we're just going to kill ourselves so your fat self won't sit on us anymore.
Please get off me, sir.
That's my just peace of my mind. Your fat self is not going to be sitting on me anymore. Just take my soul, you oppressive thing. Man.
So there you go. Calgar spirits are just body shaming at this point now.
Yeah.
So.
That's what it is.
Whew. I like it.
I don't like the way these people treat their pets. I don't like it.
You're a big advocate of playing nice with the pets in Dragonblaze, right? You got goggles on, bandana stapled onto their heads, you know.
Yeah, it's not right.
I feel like the only animal that's really treated well, at least Placarius Tiger doesn't, like, it's not being sat on or anything like that.
That thing lives the life of luxury.
Yeah, he lives pretty well.
He does.
But you have Farrah, who's sitting on top of her. It's just, it's all bad, man. And then you got, what's her name? I think it's Monolani, who's got the skulls of all the, there's some dark stuff going on here, guys. Dark stuff. Anyway, throw him in our party and take a look at his abilities in a real map. Calgar, let's do it. Raven Gale gave him a lecture on animal abuse. That's tight, yeah. Yeah, Calgar's pretty good in the PvP stun is pretty nice. The attack speed slow is actually really nice too as well. So he fits the role pretty well in a, I would say, PvP team. I also think he does pretty well in tower validation, I think, in regular hero mode. I think he does pretty well, so... But, yeah, all in all, I can see him, like, actually excelling more in PvP than anything, though, so.
Yeah.
Purifier, man. Whew! Whew! Is it getting hot in here? Yeah, I mean, his healing isn't the greatest. That's what I'm saying. He's more so situated for, like, if you, you know, either need heals but you're lacking in like DPS, he can like kind of fill in a little bit more rather than, because I think you probably lose out more on DPS than having like one dedicated healer and maybe throwing him in so he can do kind of two, you know what I mean? So yeah, by no means are his heals, you know, incredible or anything like that. He's more like a pocket pick though, you know, so let's see.
Well, he could be more of a bit of a gap closer, right? So
yeah,
if you're going through some of the upper levels and you're just getting rocked, you know, he can give you an extra buff. He isn't going to be your primary healer, but
yeah,
he can kind of hybrid a little bit.
That's true, though. Yeah, definitely. Where can I farm hero essences? I usually farm the third region in chapter 3, and it's the one that drops either the defense neck or the...
that's like Ivory Grave or
something
like that.
Or the DPS earrings. Because essentially when I'm farming both of those, I usually wait until around either the 50% multiplier for dungeon drop rates, or I know the weekends usually have the 100% ones though too. So I try to use or do most of my farming during those gaps when those actual buffs are there. So,
is Nick a part of PETA? No, I'm not.
I don't know, man. I mean, you do love animals a lot, though.
I do.
You know. So, you're becoming more vocal about,
you know, stapling bandanas to their head.
Yeah.
No, I get it.
I once stapled put a staple in my elbow, you know, when I was in high school, so, you know.
Well, you ain't an animal, so I don't care. I mean, you kind of are.
Kind of. I'm kind of heinous, but.
Aren't we all just animals? You know. Oh, man.
No, yeah, they don't necessarily buff, they don't buff the, essence rate, but the reason why I save a lot of farming for that time is because I can get not only the because sometimes they have the gold drop rate as well, but then the fact that I'm farming during a higher essence rate, I can get either the because I usually shoot to try to get the earrings. That's the thing. I don't necessarily try to farm for essences. I try to farm for, like, you know, other stuff that I'm looking for. So, like, the earrings are a big thing that I'm currently trying to get across all my characters. So I'll look to farm for those, and I find that it's totally ridiculous sounding, but I find that if I try to farm for something else other than what I want, I just somehow get it more. I don't know why mm-hmm. it happens, but yeah, I mean, that's why I'm
like
saying.
It's like watching a pot boil, though.
I don't really watch pot boils, though.
Well, no, that's what I'm saying. It's like you set it down, you're trying to go for something else, and you're not really focused on it.
Yeah.
Right? If you're going out farming essences, you're like looking at every run, being like, okay, did I get one? Oh, I didn't get one this one. Okay. What about this time? Oh, I didn't get one.
And it's especially misleading, too, especially with the event that we have going on, too, so you can get potentially triple S event items that can like kind of mislead you, where you look at the after action report, you're like, yeah, I got 5 triple S's, and it's all 5 just event items. You're like,
yeah.
So I get
thanks,
it.
Laurels.
I know.
For nothing.
Yeah. You suck. yeah, so these are the two zones I was talking about. It's Icy Fang with the earrings, or Ivory Grave with the Necklace of Howling Ghost.
Yeah.
Those two. So, now that we've taken a look at the two newest Awakened allies, we do have Guild Adventure. So, Guild Adventure is going to be a new game mode currently located in Honor Gorge between the World Boss area and Destruction Dungeon. What this is going to be, this is going to be kind of like an experience you guys might not be as familiar with, because all the other game modes are either have our open full day or this and that, but with Guild Adventure, this is only going to be open currently, as far as I know, is going to be open for 2 hours on Friday. And essentially what this is you have 9 rounds of fighting a boss that you and your guild members have to basically defeat. Mm-hmm. For those of you guys who might be familiar with, because I kind of made the comparison with Nick, who might be familiar with Kingdom of War and those raid encounters and stuff like that. Essentially, that's a guild effort, right? So this tracks real-time damage. So when you go in there, you'll see everybody that's actually attacking him. Rewards are based off of kind of the current guild PvP, the way that kind of works, where it's like you obtain a tier or you attain like a ranking of some sort, and then everybody in your guild gets those mm-hmm. rewards, right? So basically, whenever you clear an area or whenever you clear a specific round, those are the rewards that will be sent to your guild mates. And so you have rubies.
One second.
Sorry, go ahead.
Thaw Ninja, it's going to be 9 rounds for the entire guild.
Yeah.
It's not going to be per person. Yeah.
So, essentially what this does is all participants will be sent the triple S or the double S enhanced ally summon, as you see here. So once you do, and that's the thing too, there's no time frame in the actual rounds after you're fighting the guild boss. So basically those 2 hours are going to be do as much damage as possible, try to get as far or as high into a round as you possibly can. Right, so, and then these don't stack. I believe it's basically kind of like once you defeat one round, you go to the next round, and it's basically at the, as you see here, it says Guild Adventure opens 8 to 10 p.m. every Friday, and then rewards will be determined starting at 10 p.m. So essentially, it'll find what round you cleared into, and then, like I said, everybody who was participating in that will be getting rewards based on the position that, on the participation that they basically gave in, right? I just want to ask him what it was. So if you attack the boss, I haven't died, but I believe they told me that you can keep going in there. It's basically just you can keep going until the end, or until that 2 hours is over. So I don't believe there's any kind of like rule. If you do wipe, you can't go back in or anything like that. It's basically, yeah, just try to get in there and fight as much as possible. The thing you do want to be cognizant about, though, is people who are participating. While the rewards are shared across all guild members, you will, let's say, like it's open for 2 hours, and then you jump in during hour two, or yeah, so 1 hour goes by, you jump in, and then let's say your guild's now, you know, they clear 2 rounds without you. The only thing you really missed out on are just those enhanced summons, right? Because essentially, when you clear that round, or when you participate in that round, it'll give you those two. Double S. The only thing that you would basically be eligible to receive is then that round 3 enhance summon ally. And then you get those rewards then as soon as the thing ends if you do clear round three. You follow me? You look really
No, confused. Man, I'm super lost. I stopped listening. As soon as it got too wordy, I just stopped.
Yeah. No, so not everyone is getting those rubies. So the total rubies that you see here, remember how, or think of how kind of like guild PvP is rewarded, right? Where you basically say you got the max rank or whatever is here, he gets these rewards, and then everyone who participated gets these rewards. So it kind of works like that then.
Yeah, it's guild battle. Everything's split. It's not everybody's going to get 300 and some odd rubies. It's going to be split based on your participation.
I don't advocate that, Purifier. I did not advocate that. No. Yeah, so yeah, guild rubies are shared, and or guild battle rubies are shared, so basically same thing here. Another thing, too, is that you will not... Guild Adventure is not a ranking mode across other guilds or anything like that. It's basically just a solo guild mode that only you and your guild members can participate in. With that being said, the only thing that would really show up though is the in the top left hand corner you'll see first guild cleared. I think it's just for that week. Whoever clears the all nine rounds first will just have like a bragging right of like, oh, my name's up there. So it'll just show you who the first guild that could clear that is. And I don't think Hall of Fame has those as well too, since it's not a rankings across all different areas. So that's the one thing that it's not in there though. But I do believe it does have, it does have a battle mission though in there too. So that's an extra 30 rubies that you can basically get from participating in this game mode. So without further ado, let me go ahead and bring in some people in here. The cool thing about this too is any helper ally that you bring in, I believe, is a permanent ally in there. So you basically summon them and they stay in there until they either die or you kill the boss. So let me throw in, I'm just gonna throw in some random people in here just to do some damage. And add. And I'll just throw in Mercedes, whatever. So, here we go. The Talos Guard Ziggurat, who lives in an unknown territory, has appeared! Show off your guild strength by defeating Ziggurat together. Now keep in mind, as I'm going through this, this is supposed to require multiple guild members. So I'm gonna be doing damage to him, but it's gonna be very slow though. So here he comes. He's kind of like, what's going on, guys? I'm gonna punch you, punch of Talos. And then from there, there it is. We just start going to town on him. So you can see up there a couple things to kind of note in here. You have the side panel, which you can close and open with the arrow. Currently shows my top score right now. As I said, these scores do update in real time. So you can kind of see people who are taking. I know it's not a good team. I'm just...
Yeah, it was just putting people in there, guys.
Yeah. What I will do attempt, though, is turn off the... effects though, so you can actually see
what's happening.
Yeah, so
maybe you close that window pane.
Yeah, wait, hold on. And then the maybe get rid of like that giant thing that's in the middle of the screen. Yeah. And the last thing you will note too is if you see up on top of the leaderboard ranking for your guild mates, there's a bar up there that shows how much HP he's got left, and then percentage, as well as the bar will drain. I believe there's like four different colored bars: blue, green, yellow, red, to signify. That he's got how much health he's got there. So, oh yeah, let me go ahead and summon. Oh, Epsilon's already out. Yeah. So boom, let's see if we can take this guy out. 98% currently, guys. 98%. Yeah, those are the only two allies currently with the update right now.
It does run out of hit points. It's just this is meant for 30 plus people to be attacking it at one time. So it's got a ton of health.
Yeah, so currently, we haven't even, oh my god.
You're still in the billions.
Yeah.
The multiple billions. It's okay.
We'll get there eventually, my friend. We'll get there eventually.
Or we won't.
Or we just
run. Either way, I'm good.
Full 50 people in a guild, so.
Yeah, I know there's 50 people in a guild. I'm saying that they designed something not with, okay, every guild that are going to be participating has 50 people in it. So,
yeah.
Yeah. That's why I said averaging like 30 and up, which is a little bit more accurate yeah. than, hey, everybody that's going to be attacking this has 50 people.
I think, I want to say Guild Adventurer, since this is a boss, would use like the same kind of like world boss setup, I would say. I'm sure somebody would come in and correct me if I'm wrong, because I do believe this Guild Adventure boss is considered a boss type of some sort, right? So, I want to say, like, Lucian would work really well in there.
Anything with high single target damage.
Yeah. Can we get a time zone for the Guild Adventure? Ooh, I want to say that's based off the PDT.
It's probably PDT.
Probably PDT.
Pacific time.
Yeah, so Guild Adventure does reset every week. Just keep in mind, it is that 2 hours in there. So that will be Friday, 2 hours. I believe currently it's 8 to 10. I'm not sure of the actual reset day, though. Obviously, it wouldn't really matter.
Well, yeah, it doesn't matter.
Not going to open until Friday, but still.
Yeah. Yeah, so you have 2 hours to kill him essentially 9 times.
And then the higher the round that you get to, the greater the rewards that you'll...
And no, there's no timeout on the boss, unless you probably just run out of the 2 hours, it'll eventually close.
Mm-hmm. So boss damage does work? I believe it does work, yeah. Like I said, I'll have to... get clarification, or if somebody knows. Yeah, so if somebody does know. There are 9 bosses. You kill 1 to complete the round, and each successive boss is stronger. Essentially, yes. And then each boss will provide a greater number of rewards as well, too. So that's arena coins, rubies, and then if you are currently participating in the raid, you'll get the double enhanced allies, or double S enhanced allies.
If a Dark Soul was coming out with this update, we would have spoken about it already. Yeah.
Unfortunately, no Dark Souls on this update.
No.
Just rolling. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I mean, and it's cool. I mean, the only thing that I would have liked to maybe see, is either, an additional day that you can maybe participate, or maybe a little more time. Because I know that we've had some things in the past, right, where we put a kind of a time frame on that there wasn't a lot of positive feedback from something like that. So
yeah, but I mean, we've been sitting here doing this for, what, about 5 minutes now? You've already taken off 8% of its health.
Yeah.
You're one person. I would say that the time probably won't be that bad if you... I mean, if you're at a higher level and you're trying to compete with some of the top guilds, I mean, they're going to have strong people.
Of course,
you know,
yeah.
You're going to have 20, 30 people all attacking at one time. I mean, the time really shouldn't be an issue. Plus, I mean, to scale it for...
Yeah.
You know, as the levels go up and things like that and stronger allies become introduced... I don't really see it as being a problem.
Yeah, and obviously there are some like distinct differences between like this and World Boss. The Guild Adventure boss, I mean, as you can see now, he's not really getting any stronger as time goes on, right? He basically has a set stat pool for that round, and then basically you just have to, once you get to the next round, it goes, you know, further and stuff like that. So while it might be like boring the first couple of rounds because he's got so much HP, but he's not hitting at as hard, there probably will be a little bit more, like, further ally structure maybe when you get into the higher rounds because he's doing more damage or something like that, so...
Right, Mythicus, but, I mean, you consider yourself below average, but that doesn't mean that everybody else in your guild is, right? So, I honestly, like, if they had such low HP where guilds were coming in and going 9 of 9 the first time this is brought out, which... could potentially happen,
very well,
which
could,
I don't think would happen. But then it's like you brought out a game mode that's instantly completely beatable. Mm-hmm. Like it has no scaling for any future updates. So I don't really... I mean, I kind of understand what you're saying. I just don't agree.
Yeah.
Yeah, there is no limit on the number of times you can try just within that 2 hour period.
Since summer's approaching its end, are the summer outfits going to make a reappearance? Ooh, I would personally like to see that happen, though I'm not entirely sure if that will. Or I would like to actually see new, because I know we've introduced some newer allies, so it'd be kind of cool to see expanded that. Mm-hmm. With Omega Base and plus 5 Uranus, I got 530 million this week. Oh, nice. Yeah, Tanuvian's going to be really nice in World Boss. I totally forgot the fact that she can, the poison's crit, so all the heads could potentially just be getting huge crit numbers in there. It's going to be really nice, so. No, the boss damage does not increase over time in one round. That's why you're basically seeing none of my characters basically be dying, or that are dying right now, so. Look how pissed off that giant is. Well, I mean, he kind of just came out of nowhere, and he swung at us first, so, you know. Let's see. Yeah, I mean, Tanuvian's just, she's one of those, like, awakened allies that I saw at first. I think she kind of, it was the same thing with Folsom, where I saw it first, and I was kind of like, oh, yeah, I guess they're okay, and then just realized, like, how ridiculously strong they can actually be in specific game modes, right? Mm-hmm. So, yeah, don't count awakened allies out quite yet, man. Like, they, some of them shine in certain game modes, though, so.
The summer unit is just fodder. So, yeah. Master her rapport, keep her if you want, or feed her to something else. That poor girl. That poor girl.
Oh, man. I feel like I can maybe, like, swap out some of these characters to, like, do more damage, though, right? Because I have a Calgar in there who's probably not dealing as much damage as he should be. Yeah, I have that Dark Soul tier. Maybe I can enhance her a couple more times so I can expedite this a little bit further, though. So I'm currently at, what, 86%? Only 7 mil. Whoo! Would you say we have a few more mil in to go there, huh?
Man.
Just like, oh, God. Yeah, plus the Epsilon summon probably wasn't the most ideal there, huh? In Buster mode? Oh, wow, Craftsman. That hurts.
Dude, Tanuvian is... She's no joke.
That's pretty stupid, man. Yeah.
I like it. Mine's already ultimate. Wait, is mine plus 4 or ultimate already?
I thought you said you were working towards her ultimate.
No, it's either max plus 4 or it's ultimate already. I can't
remember. Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
So basically, if I die in that round, I can go back in the same round and fight. Yes!
Guys, we weren't trying to, like, kill this thing. We were just showing it off for you.
Yeah.
We're not competing for everything, so.
If I wanted to kill him off, I would have, like, had him at, like, 15% and gone in and...
Tanuvian is death, yes. Yes, she is.
Let me, I'm gonna back out really quickly and just, put someone else in. Boom! Acquired points, 9 million. Okay.
Do y'all consider how late everything is for East Coast people? I mean, I can't speak for the developers, but I mean, I probably not. You know, I mean, PST seems to be the going rate for all of our stuff. So, mm-hmm. Sorry. In the DB mailbox, huh? I don't know.
Who is better for a key summon for Epsilon, Mercedes or Chabelle?
Probably Chabelle.
I would probably say Chabelle as well, too.
Because if she's going to die, then you have the AoE res. So, I'm not really a fan of Mercedes, but, you know, that's just kind of a personal thing for me. Let's check this Dragon Blaze mailbox real quick.
Yeah. No, I want to see it. Let's see. I wanted to do a warrior number one. Let's see. All right, so he's changed out some people here. Obviously, he'll still go pretty slow, but Yeah, I put in, I realized I didn't have Lucian in my team, so I put her in there with a stigma.
Oh yeah, what's that?
Huh? You know, just when I think you didn't have any, then you just, you know.
Hey man,
one,
I just lay low.
Right
I just
there,
lay
huh?
low for a little bit, and then spring it on you.
Yeah, I know I did, didn't I? 80%. Let me do that right now, then. Good, good call out on that one, by the way. I think there's a little bit better team though. Okay. Let's try that again. You didn't see nothing.
The answer to your question, Craftman, is no. No, I am not.
Oh, he sent you something?
Yeah.
Let's see. Will there be a shop item that boosts your character to level 90? As Nick said, I know there was changes to the jar in, what'd you say, Chapter 4 for the Korean version. So, but currently there's no changes though to the jar to boost you to level 90 right now.
I mean, you'll find out on here first.
I don't have that kind of time, Crudabeast. I'm getting married in October. Any advice? Ooh,
that's.
Well, first of all, congrats before any words
first
are said.
Of all, congrats.
Yeah.
Just be patient. The first year
can
be rocky. Just be patient and figure out, you know, figure out what. I'm not going to be like these people and tell you don't do it. You know, that's silly. You know, if you find somebody that you love, marry them. It's fine. But just be patient because it takes a little getting used to.
Craftsman. I don't even know what you sent him, and I think that's a bad idea.
Oh, it's just something talking about him raiding with you and asking me if I'm jealous.
Oh.
Which the answer would be no.
No.
Yeah. So.
Dang. Kong Yang, do you feel that way, Nick, too?
That's absolutely a fallacy.
Yeah. Especially if you guys know Nick, you know he's very just like if you're wrong about something or if he knows, like, he brings it to the table, man. It's no joking matter.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I am Joker, the passive that she brings, which is the 56% additional boss damage, carries over into Stigma as well, too. Is the max ally limit in Korea more than 110 allies right now? I wouldn't know that. You have to maybe go ask somebody who plays that. I don't know, currently.
No.
Are we also getting the...
No, there's no... I don't think there's a DPS counter in the new update. These guys and their marriage advice is hilarious.
Woo!
Who's the best buster in your opinion? I really like Iota. A lot of people like Stigma. It just kind of depends on what you're trying to do.
Yeah, I think Tyr is pretty much up there right now. Now that she's out, I think she's kind of maintains I would say the top.
Yeah, but that's not a buster.
Or I meant like just, I guess I was talking about Buster and Dark Soul together now that they're built out, so never mind. Or Omega, yeah, Omega, I know everyone always says though, only get Omega if you have the DPS to support that, right? Because Omega is definitely a support Dragon Buster, so if you have just, like, doo-doo DPS, you're basically just going to be supporting doo-doo DPS, you know? What is that? Not a...
No, man, I just love the size.
So, see, look at that. Look how much faster we're going now on this now. We started with this team at, what, 80%?
Mm-hmm.
And now we're going to work them down. I think we'll actually defeat this round until, we're at the end of the show. Portals are also the best, yes. Though, once again, Nick would argue that's not a buster.
Yeah. It's just a mushroom. A portal
buster, huh?
Again, no noise. This is meant to have tons of people attacking it at the same time. Joe's just one person.
Yeah, I think you guys really underestimate
what's the rest of your guild members.
Yeah, yeah, because like you
and
like,
we're telling them.
Yeah, I mean, just like even if you have like even if there's three other people doing it, you guys like it's gonna go down. Like obviously this is the first two or three or whatever might be probably relatively more easier because they have a lower HP pool. But then like once you start getting into those higher end rounds, that's when it's gonna kind of get over the top though, right?
Mm-hmm.
So. Yeah, I mean, really, I know we say it, you know, all the time about either characters or allies that we have out, but reserve your judgment for the game mode for when you actually try it in, like, your actual guild. Because you can only see so much that I'm doing right now by myself in a guild that it's like, of course it looks like it's going to take forever, you know, but... Are we really underestimating Joe's no crit damage? I try to get crit damage, Purifier. You know what? I have terrible luck pulling some of these weapons that just have a crit rate, and that's it. You know what I mean? So it's like, what am I going to do? Not use an item because it doesn't have it? Well, I got to get it.
Oh, sorry. Yeah? You good?
You got a little heated there, so...
Really? Well, you're ventilated enough.
Yeah, I got to readjust my V-neck now. Got my V-neck on.
I can't help Joe out because I don't have the test server build right now. So he's by himself.
What up?